In today's episode, it is shown how to utilize an Arduino Uno, an HX711 breakout board, and a load cell in order to measure weight. Moreover, an LCD module of type LCM1602 IIC version 1 is used to display the measured weight. So in a few minutes, you should know everything you need to make a basic weighing scale featuring a digital display. The HX711 is a 24-bit analog-to-digital converter which fits perfectly to weighing scale applications. Fortunately, there exist many breakout boards for the HX711, such as this one. Therefore, it is very easy to use it in combination with such a load cell. Load cells are transducers that convert pressure into an electrical signal. Typically, the resulting electrical signal has only a few millivolts, therefore it must be amplified. And that's when this HX711 module comes in, as it amplifies the weak signal to a few volts so that we can read the signal with the help of an Arduino Uno. If you buy such a load cell, they often come with conventional wires. As a first step, I add female to power connectors to the wires. As a result, I will be able to easily connect the wires to the HX711 module. Keep in mind that this step is totally optional. You can use whatever you want to connect the wires to the pins of the HX711 module. If you use the power connectors, keep in mind that such load cells often have thin, single-stranded wires. I used the help of some solder to attach the thin wires more tightly to their connectors. You will be able to retrieve consistent pressure values from the load cell if you mount the load cell on something that is solid and heavy. I use a part of an old square timber for this task. Conveniently, the load cell has already some holes, so you can mount it tightly with only two screws. Let's start with connecting the load cell to the HX711 module. The module has 6 pins. In this tutorial, we need only 4 of them. The remaining 2 pins are required if a second load cell has to be connected to the same HX711 module. As far as I know, most load cells have the same color code. If you are not sure about the color code of your load cell, then have a look into the datasheet. This load cell has 4 wires. Red has to be connected to the E+ pin. Black has to be connected to the E- pin. By the way, E stands for excitation. Then the white wire has to be connected to the A- pin. And the remaining wire, the green one, must be connected to A+. Next, the HX711 module is connected to the Arduino. The first pin, ground, must be connected to one of the Arduino's ground pins. The next two pins, DT and SCK, must be connected to digital pins. In this tutorial, I use pin 4 for DT and pin 5 for SCK. VCC must be connected to the Arduino's 5V pin. As the LCD module requires also the 5V pin, I'll make use of a small breadboard to split the 5V signal. Now the LCD module is connected to the Arduino. You find the pin labels on the back. Ground must be connected to the Arduino's ground. VCC must be connected to the 5V signal of the breadboard. SDA to the Arduino's SDA. And SCL to the Arduino's SCL. And that's it. In order to give you a better overview of the wiring, I'll show you the corresponding fritzing file for a few moments. For more convenient development, I recommend to use the Liquid Crystal I2C library and the HX711 ADC library. Here you see how I install the HX711 ADC library. The installation of the Liquid Crystal I2C library is not shown, as I had already installed it. Nonetheless, the Liquid Crystal I2C library is not less important, since the library makes it very easy to work with the LCM1602 LCD module. Then let's have a look into the source code. First, we need to add some header files, and then we create an object that represents the load cell, as well as an object that represents the LCD module. In the setup function, we start with initializing the load cell object. The probably most important method call is this one. Here we set the calibration factor. Later we will have to change this factor from 1 to something else. Then we initialize the LCD module. In the loop function, we retrieve the data from the load cell. Then we set the cursor of the LCD module to the first row and print out a label. The label will indicate that we intend to show the weight in grams. Next, we set the cursor to the second row and print out the retrieved value from the load cell. Now I transmit the program to the Arduino. If I put something on the scale, the displayed value is way too high. As I mentioned before, we need to set a calibration factor in order to make it work. If you have so-called calibrated weights, this step becomes very easy. As I do not own such calibrated weights, I require a second scale, from which I know that it works correctly. Now I can put my DC motor on the second scale and retrieve the correct weight. Next, I have to change the calibration factor and to re-upload the program until my scale shows the same weight. Here I'm satisfied with the accuracy. It makes total sense to double check the calibration factor. Just take something else and put it on your scale of trust. Then put it on your new scale and it should display a very similar value. There's still a lot of room for improvement. For example, if you put something on another spot of the load cell, the displayed value changes strongly. You can overcome this issue by, for example, mounting a blade on top of your load cell. Okay, but that's it for this episode. I hope I could give you a good start in building weighing scales based on the Arduino platform and load cells. Thanks for watching and goodbye.